guys, MidnaLikesWaffles here. Hope you can hear me in the game. And I'm pretty sure this isn't made by that game company, but they might have some of the same people who did sound. But if I have to pick between Journey and ABZU, my favorite, ABZU wins, hands down. I love looking at water. I like looking at fish, but it's too frustrating to own a fish tank. Plus, with OCD, can you imagine me cleaning a fish tank? I don't want to imagine that. But this is another game where the story isn't clear. There's just bits and pieces that the game gives you to put together. And much like Journey, I did not discover this lore by myself. I looked it up, because I'm terrible at research and digging into things on my own. I've already gotten all the achievements for this and for Journey, so unfortunately I can't show you that. But for now, ABZU, let us discover what it holds. Our character. Huh? I'm gonna put something in editing right there, but can you see that? Is it just me, right? Is the sky that shouldn't be there? Still there. I'm just loving this because of how the sunlight reflects onto the water and causes those lights on the sand. Ugh, so nice. Push X slowly to get those speed ups. If you do it rapidly, it doesn't seem to work too well. Gotten everything, I'm gonna miss a couple details, but nothing I can do about that. These cause more fish to be in the area. Let's see if I can do this real quick. Grab camera. That was terrible. Let's try that again. More feeling. crappy, but better. Okay, our goal is to continue on. But look at all the pretty fishies. Yes, I see. Sea urchins. There you go. More than one, but I'm just gonna get the required amount. You only need one. Shark. He seemed to be in a hurry. Yes, follow the huge shark. This looks like a great idea. I think not all sharks are necessarily violent, but you never can know for certain. I've always said that animals are more predictable than people. While that's true to an extent, sometimes you can't predict what they're gonna do either. This is awfully gloomy compared to everything else we've seen. Except for that little blue light down there. That was a better jump. I'm satisfied. Where are you? There you are. This place is so gloomy. Let's fix that by bringing this sucker up. Saw that a minute ago in the opening. I'm probably gonna be done recording when I finish this. I've done quite a bit, and I have something on YouTube I want to watch. Treasure, and they look a lot more like our character here. If you collect all the seashells in the game, you get a different appearance for your character. I'm not gonna bother with it though. Don't feel like it. I'm not coming up to a part I'm not too fond of. I like blue, but apparently I don't like this shade of blue. For some reason, it bugs me. I can't get myself to like this color of blue in this area. Just, yeah. Don't like it. I mean, it's not a bad shade of blue, but for some reason, I don't like it. I don't like this color. I don't know why. It's weird. Maybe it's because of the area it's in. I don't know. But I don't like that shade of blue. Eh. I don't understand why. It's kind of strange. Now, if you hit any extra robots, they would go down into some slots that would open up. But I didn't bother getting them. Okay, I'm totally gonna edit out loading screens in this thing. Jeez, that was ridiculous. That was longer than a Skyrim loading screen or a Bloodborne loading screen. Well, maybe when the Bloodborne first came out, it would have been exact. Or longer. Jeez, man. You'll get an achievement for breaking into schools of fish. I think it's 20 or 15. I'd look at the achievement if I were you, because I don't remember. And this is so cool, too. Yes, is that a coral? Oh my. That is coral, isn't it? It looks to be the right shape, but it could be grass for all I know. I don't know much about my land flora and fauna. I know crap all about the ocean stuff. I know even less. Don't be. Pretty fishies. All the yellow ones and the white ones. All the colors of the fishies. Just look around at this stone underwater. It's nuts. Got ourselves an underwater pathway. Are those Napoleon fish? I've caught them at Animal Crossing before. They're probably not. I can't really get a good look. Jellyfish. There's the shark again. What are these? Will they close if I get close? Oh, yes they will! Noted. Yes. we can get a closer look at the fishies. Garden. Speaking of, when this video goes up, it'll be my birthday in a few months. I'm really hoping someone gets me the HDMI splitter. That'll make everything so much easier on me. Hey guys, what's up? Oddly enough, after watching Jurassic Park a couple times, I want to watch Land Before Time again. Which is kind of funny, all things considered. Petri wasn't a vegetarian! He's a carnivore. Meat eater, whatever. Dang it, I can't say these big words. Oh, yes, 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 epic jump part! Epic jump part! Go! I love that every time. And then they're gone because this area is putrid. It's unhealthy, there's no color, it's all gloomy. We must do something about this. And we will. There's another little temple right here, after all. Or whatever it's probably called. Yeah, robot, you scared me. Again, but still, it's pretty. I'm sorry, me and the color pink can't get along. I don't mind it in some shades, depending on how it's used, but most of the time, pink and I are friends. We just stay out of each other's way. Pink can go and hang out with all the people that do appreciate it. So we got more paintings on the wall. Shark and that orb we've been using. Yay, more of this blue shade. Wonderful, it's just what I wanted to see. I really can't tell you why this color bugs me. I don't like it. Maybe if there was more greenery, it wouldn't be so bad, but that just straight blue, I don't know. I just can't stand it. So weird. And see, then the robot friend goes. Turn that while you're underwater. You've got even more water in water, rather say underwater. Turkeyfish? It's went past it, so I couldn't really tell. Well, there's the shark again. Well, he's minding his own business. Don't narrow your eye at me, you stupid machine. I'm allowed to think well of the shark. He's not pestering you, is he? Places. It won't be like this for long. I'm gonna make it all pretty again. Unless, of course, if I missed the stupid entrance. Hi. There we go. Results of the other ones you've already awoken by looking around. That's neat. How the plant life sways with the water. I love the light effects inside water. It's so pretty. How it just shines against rock. If said rock is arguably clean, it shines anyway. And now this is different. This looks like an actual building was once here. That we've been seeing, you take the red pots, fill them, they gain those orbs, and dump them into the ocean, and it creates life. So that orb that we've been pulling out of our character into those blobs of whatever has been restoring the ocean. So it appears this civilization was once using the pots to transport this stuff and bring it to the ocean to restore it. Eventually, they found a better way to do it. And that way was with their machines. Those triangle things. But they're up to their best. Right here. We've clearly been seeing that there's pieces of the ocean that are in terrible condition. And these places appear to be abandoned, so clearly something went wrong down the line. The shark statue stalled me for a minute. It was all pointy. It's like, ah, what the heck? And these people worshipped the Great White as a type of god. He is the guardian of the ocean for them. He protects it, and so they give tribute to it. Broken down triangular machine right there. Something that should have been keeping the ocean safe and healthy. And look, here's another one. Doors we've been using. So something obviously happened that wasn't supposed to. I mean, the creators of these machines are gone. All that's left is ruins underwater. And of course, their creations. I can appreciate this dim lighting. It's still rather pretty in its own way. Like that every time they did that on purpose. Hi. Nice to meet you. Let's do barrel rolls together. Whee! More of this deep blue color. Yay! I don't get why I dislike this shade of blue. It's strange. Whatever. I'm gonna stop commenting on it. Just ignore it. Won't be in this area too long if I can help it. There's more of these triangular machines. This is gonna happen regardless of what I do here, so let's just get it over with at least once. You get too close to one. It zaps you. They're little mines. They slow you down. Hey, Squid. These things are everywhere down here. Zapped, but if I can avoid it, I'd like to. Well, that didn't work that I wanted it to. Ah, double zap. Triple? Leave me alone, dude! What a jerk! I'm trying to get around you, you're not making it easy. Oh, come off it! I told you what's gonna happen. Stop zapping me! Oh, I think each of them has hit me at least once now. Turn off, you bunch of pieces of beep. Jeez, I could not get through there. Now here, as you can see, all these machines, they're designed to help the ocean, but they're locking the sea life out of that area and attacking anything that does try to get through, as we saw for what happened to our character. Our character was zapped rather viciously. Ninja, you stinkers. Those ones are easier to get around. And now... Oh, there goes our shark friend. Now, since he's the guardian of the ocean, he wants these machines gone. Because they're doing nothing good for it. It's no wonder he attacked the little robot we picked up. It was a machine, after all. Oh, explosion. What happened? Oh dear. Looks like the shark either got zapped by this thing, or attacked that thing and ended up getting stuck. Now, I know sharks can't stop moving, so let's get him out of there. I gotcha. Just because my character's machine does not mean I have to dislike you. See? I'm friendly. Not a threat to you. Hey, now the shark knows that you're not... Just because you're one of those machines that he's trying to get rid of, doesn't mean you're just like him. More whales! Wait! There's a giant squid down here, you can see him. Oh, so cool! Achievement for doing this. Wee. Alright, leave you alone. There's one single red squid in a very gloomy, non-colorful area. What the heck? Why do they do that? Oh, this area looks really dead. Everything else doesn't look that good, but this looks completely dead. Let's fix that. Let's restore some more life to this ocean. The shark will be our friend. Because after all, we've saved him and restoring his ocean. You'll see we're not like the other machines, after all. Quite a great deal better. And there's more squids. There's more squids. Some of those fish almost look skeletal. There's just one little opening here. Alright, character. It's about to get creepy. Got this huge huge giant triangle thing and all the mines. The shark is going right in there. You bet we're chasing him down. He's gonna get himself hurt. We need to be there to get him out of trouble if he gets into it. Okay, I can dodge some of these pretty okay. There's always that chance I mess up. Okay, I'm good. Let's follow the shark. Need to keep him safe. Given to the machines. That was not what it was created to do. It was not to take for itself, it was meant to collect and restore. It was disobeying its instructions. So is it too far-fetched to believe that it destroyed its creators for trying to stop it? And so in a last-ditch effort, they sent away their best creation in hopes that their best creation would team up with the Guardian and bring down the other machines. If you look up, you can see movement, but those aren't fish, they're machines. Observant would already notice that your character's probably not human. This imagery of the little robots, those triangles, and then you. Your character is a machine designed to restore the ocean, but your character is the only one that's following the directives. Other machines no longer are. And they'll continue to destroy and overtake the ocean if it's not stopped. Which is gonna be what the shark is trying to do, stop it. Its results haven't been good so far. Definitely gonna get zapped up ahead. There's way too many. Soundtrack here is so good. No! That's as bad as Upper Cathedral Ward of Bloodborne. I don't like that. It's creepy in some way. Well, I said it was gonna happen. No! At least these ones disappear, the other ones from before just reset themselves. Oh, man, I bet that hurt. And there's no safe area. This is still inside the triangle thing. If you look up, you can see there's a roof. Or some sort. You're still inside the machine. Here's the heart of the machine. How do you begin to stop it, though? Well, the shark has an idea. Not an overly effective one, though. It's getting zapped. We both got zapped. And then you can see without a doubt that yes, your character is indeed a machine. Both you and the shark get taken out. But look, your character's still able to function. Just got stunned pretty bad. all this wreckage down here. Clearly the shark was busy. And look, there he is. That zap did a worse number on him than the character. Quick, we gotta get over there. It's okay. I'm here. I like how the character's eyes got wide and then shut in regret. You won't be forgotten. We'll do our best for you. We promise. We'll set things right. We will restore the ocean. I didn't have a choice but to resurface there. It makes you do it. However, I think it does that so to show you that you can get out of the water. Your character is designed to swim, but capable of walking. Creatures hanging out up here, too. Machines can't reach these guys. Since this character is a machine, that wouldn't do any damage to them like it would a person. I never used to understand why they always say your feet need to be straight when you jump into water. But when I watched the guy discuss Breath of the Wild Link jumping off towers into water and how he would not survive that, I didn't understand all the math of it. But I've understood enough that I know that that would kill Link. And that there have been professional divers who have set world records and they've actually dislocated something or broken something. Stuck here before, that was funny. It really was. I felt so stupid when I finally found that spot. I never like doing cannonballs into pools or lakes. In fact, once I'm in the water, I tend not to get out until I'm sure I don't want to come back in, because then you have to readjust to the water all over again. That sucks. Especially my type of body. It's really weird. My body automatically adapts to the temperature around me. And normally that'd be an okay thing, but it's not, because even my body adapts to the temperature, it adapts too much, and then I get way too cold or way too hot. It's strange. My friend Maria said the same thing happens to her. Over there, I need to go say hi to. That fish has got huge eyes. Hey, buddy. Let's be friends. Hi. Whoa. Looks like he's wearing armor. Cool. Dinosaur. I don't know what your actual dinosaur name is, however, but you look like one. And not that thing, this thing. Hi! What's your name? I can't barrel roll it. I don't even know. Seriously, those fish have really big eyes. That's crazy. If some of them glow and light up, what the hey? More water underwater time. Statues of sharks are holding jars, or jugs, just like the people in the paintings. So they really, those people really cared for the sharks. And the sharks protected the ocean, especially that great white we saw. He unfortunately got killed. but we'll avenge him somehow. We'll bring down those machines. Controlling this save for the beeping and the barrels. Can't even speed up. More of these paintings. Oh, they look interesting. Hi. None of the fish even care about your character. They're just like, meh, we got something else going on. Like I said, things went terribly, terribly wrong. Alright, here we go. Another jet stream. More schools of fish to break up. Here we go. slots have been restored. Some of those pictures, he was in the middle of all these things. Since you've restored him, he will restore you. Because you've proven that you follow what your creators wanted you to do. Keep the ocean safe and alive. The rest of their machines have not done that. So now it is time to get rid of those stupid things. Now this I can control, just a little bit. Follow us. And look, if we jump now. No, I can't jump right here. Can I jump here? Yes, I can. Boom! Oh, that was perfect. The fish will jump with you. It's so cool. Now for us, no, this doesn't have to be a direct hit against these guys, but you don't have to speed up to do it either. I just thought you did at first, but I learned as I kept playing. Now the fish do a little spin too. No, 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 no. Take that machine. Restoring the ocean. You've been hogging all the power of the ocean for yourself. Now we're taking it back. Putting it where it's supposed to be. How dare you take what ain't yours? And then try to destroy the ocean in the process? Absolutely not, pal. I wasn't trying to jump, guys, but okay. It's kind of hard to control sometimes. I don't know how the shark feels about being ridden. Myself. I can. You know, I don't dig that though. This is more epic with the shark. Come here, dude. We're doing this together, not by ourselves. Come on. We're tag teaming this piece of crap. I've always done this with you. I'm always going to finish it with you. Let's get this piece of trash. We're gonna come scrap! Taking a break from recording when I'm done here. I need a drink real bad. By the way, there's penguins back over that direction. I'll point it out in editing. Should be a blue line over there. Sharky. We're going after this piece of scum together. I didn't mean to do that. Oh gosh, I bounced off the wall! Okay, stop that. Come on. Now's not the time to be finicky. Let's go. Shark friend, where are you? Oh, that red was intense. Get destroyed! Get out of my ocean! You're next! Ain't zapping us this time. I can't control this whatsoever. And so, the ocean is restored. And you can completely interact with this part. I have a hard time with it though because of the way the controls are set up. Shark, come back. The ocean is restored. All the other machines are gone, so it's just your character and the shark now. Your character will never abuse the power of the ocean like the other machines did. I did not mean to surface right there. See, this confuses me here because I have a hard time telling which way I'm going. I'm knocked down. Dang it! See, this is hard. Try to get close to the screen. Shell hidden in this credits scene as well. The shark still barrel rolls with you. I'm just gonna keep the character floating about right there. But just like Journey, absolutely gorgeous and lovely. And it's a joy to play. this one, however, you don't get to have a companion. Except for those little robots and the shark, of course. That fish is having a problem swimming. There you go, dude, you got it. The other way. Shark. Dang it. I'm trying to bring him closer to the screen. Oh, now where'd I go? Oh, dang it, serpent. Oh my gosh, I'm trying to get a good thumbnail. That'll do right there, if I remember. Okay, but that was ABZU. I hope you all enjoyed. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!